most of the activities in our daily lives are governed by choices. It is everyone's responsibility to make decisions, and the earlier a decision is made, the better, no matter how hard the decision is. The type of choices one makes in life portray a big picture. As J.K. Rowling said, it is our choices that show what we truly are, far more than our abilities. However, most of us have been having challenges in making decisions, for example, choosing a career path due to the fear of regretting it later, or by being discouraged by people, and also based on our inabilities. There are various career paths one may follow, and in most cases we happen to be uncertain of which one to follow, as there are numerous careers in life, for example, carpentry, law, engineering, dentistry, nursing, singing, modeling, teaching, and many more. My name is Susan from Taylor's College. I've had challenges in choosing my career. I've always wanted to be a doctor ever since I was young, because I used to admire how the doctors looked when they wore the white coat and the stethoscope around their neck. It was my dream to look like them. Now that I've grown up, I've realized that there's a lot more involved in medicine than just wearing the white coat. It all requires dedication and sacrificing your time. This is one of the reasons that has discouraged me to major in medicine, as it is time consuming. I was privileged to interview a neurosurgeon and a physiotherapist for my physics interview project to help me gain full knowledge on what is involved in medicine, as it is the career path I want to follow.
You can.
My name is Susan from Taylor's College, and I'd like to interview you, but first of all, I'd like to know your name.
Dr. Peter Ng.
What is your profession?
A doctor.
What motivated you to career?
I had a tragic incident when I was about 8 years old. My father died of a heart attack. And I always figured that he didn't do enough to revive him. And I wanted to be in a profession that perhaps could have saved my father's life. So that's why I wanted to be a doctor, to make a difference. His death brought great misery to our family, in a huge difference. So if that kind of death could be prevented, what would they say? That would be a good thing, so I'd make a difference. So I decided to be a doctor from that day on.
How long did you choose career?
Well, I chose my career when I went in high school.
What is your daily routine?
Well, I go to the clinic, I see patients there, and if there are emergencies, I also see them. I'm a surgeon, so I operate the same day quite a lot. Aside from the emergency.
Are you able to cope with the amount of work?
Yeah, not at all. That I can continue to work as a to a ripe old age and make a difference in my life.
Which hospital do you work in?
I work at the Sion Medical Center. I should be
here.
It's a good hospital, it's very professionally run, and all the latest equipment, so I thought I'd be happy with it.
How do you react to it?
Well, emergencies happen all the time. But last night I had an emergency surgery at 2:00 a.m. You just have to be on call and alert, and then you put your mind to emergency mode and get on with the job. That's how you need to prepare.
Are there any people in Paris? Any people in Paris?
Yes. I think my mother was in Paris. Encouraging your friends.
So what are some of the
things that you've been doing? Well, you've got to have an inquisitive mind. You have a science. You like to work. You have to work with your hands. You need to have a kind of mechanical attitude that you can use your hands to work.
How demanding is it?
Well, It is the mother.
Yes.
It is the mother.
Yeah.
Because you have to make decisions quickly, and you will be judged on the decision. The threat of legal suits are always there, so you got to accept.
Okay.
And so those are basically the challenges.
Why does it take?
Well, you have to take science, like chemistry, biology, physics, in high school.
What are some of the things
that you
are encouraging to go into this college? I'd like to interview you concerning your profession. But before we start, can you introduce yourself? What is your name?
Hi Susan, I'm Aaron.
Okay. What is your profession?
I work as a physiotherapist.
Okay. What motivated you to choose your profession?
Okay. I wanted to do something in the medical line, but I didn't want to do medicine in particular. So I wanted something similar, and physio was the next choice.
Okay. So why have you chosen to specialize in the field, considering that there are a lot of challenges in it?
One thing it's the gratification after, like, in normal terms, like some people go into their jobs, they want to do something, you know, beneficial. So I think physio, because it's more related to rehabilitation, so that helps people, number one. And I wanted something medical to its original function from after maybe 2 years or something.
Okay, so what is your daily work routine?
So I work in the center, so I get there and basically we are on based on appointments. So the patients come in, set their appointments, and then we go in and treat when they come in. So it's quite fixed.
Okay, so are you able to cope with the amount of work that you have every day?
Yes, it's not too much of an issue.
Okay, so what are some of the things that you do when you reach your place of work?
So, like I said, it's fixed in appointment basis.
Okay.
So, as they come, we treat them based off their problems that we have assessed prior to that. So, we treat them and then recommend the exercises to take home to continue their rehab.
Okay, so how do you react to emergencies in cases where maybe an emergency at midnight? How would you react to such?
In physio line, not exactly. We have so much emergency because it's a fixed 9-to-5 working hours, so we don't really get emergencies as much because it's not like in the hospital.
So, are there any people who encourage you to choose your profession?
Yes, because I've consulted a few friends who are in similar lines but not exactly in physio, and they recommend physio as one of the up and coming, so to say, in Malaysia.
So, what are your aspirations for the future?
Mainly to obviously improve my skill in treatment and assessment, and mainly focusing on hands on skills.
So, what are some of the science related subjects that you do to help you become a physiotherapist?
The most important one would be biology.
Okay,
because study about the body and function, how everything works together to perform a movement. So mainly biology, perhaps a bit of physics, because what I prefer is a lot of manual handling skills. So we have to use our body's mechanics to help execute the job while reducing the amount of energy expenditure.
Okay. So in Malaysia, are there any universities that you would encourage me to go to that are more related to physiotherapists? Like they have good lecturers and doctors. Yeah, maybe their environment is good for studying physiotherapy.
Okay. I may be a bit biased, but because I studied in Masa University, so Masa is one of the earlier ones that has started the course in physio in Malaysia. So that's why I chose. But there are a number of other bad for their studies.
Okay. So how demanding is your career path?
It is very, it's not very demanding, but it's more demanding on the physical. Like, because you, as therapists, have to exert a lot of energy to treat a patient. So, in more terms of physical demand.
So in Malaysia, what is the employment rate for physiotherapists?
In Malaysia, as of now, there are a lot of women in Malaysia. It's just that they are not in the urban areas, out of the big cities. So there may be availabilities, but there are a lot of people who are still jobless in a sense because they want to prefer their preferences in the cities.
Oh, so it means that if I to graduate today, it will be easier for me to get employed.
It will be easier if you do not have any preferences. So like I said, I can work anywhere, you know, transport, then that's fine. You'll be able to find jobs.
Okay. Thank you very much. I've learned a lot from this interview, and it was so nice having you. Thank you. How long was it?
To conclude, I'd like to acknowledge the following people for making it possible for me to carry out this project. Dr. Peter Ng and the physiotherapist Aaron Kiang for making time for me to interview them despite their busy schedules. And Florence Mnalula for offering more support, and Mary Kocha Puma for recording the interview. I have learned a lot from this interview in that I was able to compare their views based on the same question. For example, when I asked them about what motivated them to choose their career. Dr. Peter Ng's response was heartbreaking as he lost his father when he was just 8 years old. While Mr. Kiang's response was that he wanted to do something related to medicine. I also found out that physics is one of the essential subjects that one is supposed to take in order to pursue a career in medicine. May I take this opportunity to encourage anyone who has had difficulties in choosing their career to also interview people who have experience in various fields. This will help them to gain more knowledge about different careers.